Today, we are building a complete authentication system in Laravel 12, totally from scratch. No Breeze, no JT Stream, no Fortify, just pure Laravel. We will go step by step and explain in details user registration, login with RememberMe, email verification, password resets, and login throttling. By the end, you will have a fully working Auth system that you can usually use in your projects. And more importantly, you will understand how it all works under the hood. First, we need a fresh Laravel 12 project. Open your terminal and run composer create project Laravel Auth app. This gives us a brand new Laravel app. Laravel comes with authentication scaffolding, but today we are building it ourselves so you can fully understand how it works. Authentication starts with a database table for storing users. Laravel already provides us a migration for users. The username, email, email verified at, password, remember token. So this is the backbone of our authentication system. Also, we need to handle password resets. Laravel includes a password reset tokens migration out of the box that stores the user's email, a reset token, and when the token was created. By the way, never store raw tokens. If your database leaks, attackers could innocently hijack accounts. Always hash reset tokens the same way we hash passwords. Now let's check config auth.php. This file controls how Laravel handles authentication. Like here we have guards define how users are authenticated, providers tell Laravel where to find users, passwords, settings for password resets. This config is the glue that connects our migrations, models, and auth logic together. Now that our database and config are ready, let's take a look at the user model. This is where Laravel connects your user table to PHP code. So here, we need to add must verify email. So Laravel knows this model requires email verification. Next, let's define our authentication routes. We group registration, login, and password reset routes under guest middleware. So logged in users cannot see them. The logout route is under Auth middleware because only logged in users should log out. We also define email verification routes using signed URLs to prevent tampering. And finally, the home route is protected with Auth and verified middlewares. Here is the registration page. It collects a username, email, password, and password confirmation. And at the bottom, there is a quick link back to the login page for users who already have an account. In the register controller, we validate inputs, create the user with a hashed password, and fire the registered event, which triggers the verification email. Then we log them in and regenerate the session for security. Laravel uses session IDs to track authentication. If you don't regenerate the session after logging in, the old session ID will still be valid. This leaves us open to session fixation attacks. And finally, we redirect to the verification notice. In the login page, we've got a form that pulls to the login route. It has the usual fields, email, password, and the remember me checkbox. Notice the CSRF directive. This protects us from cross-site request forgery attacks. In the login controller, we validate the request, then use a rate limiter to protect against brute force attacks. If the user fails too many times, they are logged out temporarily. If the credentials are correct, we regenerate the session and redirect them home. For logout, we call Auth logout, invalidate the session, regenerate the CSRF token, and send them back to the login page. Clean and secure. Here we have the email verification page. When users register, they ask to confirm their email address. Here we show them a friendly message and give them a button to resend the verification link if needed. We even show a green success message if a new link was sent. And below that, there is a logout button in case they want to sign out. In the email verification controller, we generate a temporary signed URL, email it to the user, and when they click, we confirm it by checking the hash. If valid, we set email verified at to now. This way, only verified users can access protected routes. In the forget password blade file, the user just entered the email and Laravel will send them a reset link. The form submits to the password.email route, and we include validation error messages under the input, so users know if something went wrong. And in the reset password deplete file, this is where users actually set a new password. The form includes hidden fields for the reset token and the email address, both required for the password reset flow. Now, let's go to the password reset controller. We generate a random token, hash it, and store it in the password reset token staple. Then, we send the token in a link to the user's email. When they click the link, we check if the token is valid and not expired. If everything checks out, we update the password, delete the token, and log the user back in. And that's it. We just built a full Laravel 12 authentication system completely from scratch. We covered registration, login, logout, remember me, email verification, password reset with tokens, and even login throttling. Now you fully understand how Laravel Auth works under the hood. Next time, we can extend this with two-factor authentication, social logins, or role-based permissions. If this was helpful to you, give it a like, subscribe for more Laravel deep dives, and let me know in the comments what Auth feature you want me to add next. Thank you, and see you in the next video.